He had previously worked as an engineer or scientist for Marconi. The bar was his second career and, like me, he hadn't been to public school. He was very down to earth. Starting pupillage was tremendously exciting. I had watched proceedings from the public gallery at the Old Bailey in Bristol Assizes, but I had never actually witnessed a case from the well of the court. I vividly remember my first day as a pupil. As part of a privately funded defence team for a woman charged with a cheque fraud, Ronnie was being led by a Queen's Counsel, Michael Eastham, a more senior barrister. QCs generally appear in more serious cases and can command higher fees than an ordinary barrister, as I would learn in due course. Becoming one is not easy. The case was held in an elegant townhouse in St. James's Square, the former home of Lady Astor, who was the first woman to take her seat in the House of Commons. She had left her house to the nation, and in those days London was short of courts. The case was adjourned on day one, and the defendant's husband took us all off to Fortnum and Mason for lunch, which I thought tremendously grand. I remember thinking I could live with 12 months of this. It was the last free lunch I had for years. Michael and Ronnie won the trial. For me, it was a case of watching and learning. I was more interested in how the barristers behaved in front of the court than in the legalities of the case. Michael was very distinguished and went on to become a High Court judge. My first court case simply reinforced to me that the courts were where I wanted to work. For most of the first 6 months of my pupillage,